Yes, a very good evening. Welcome to Off the Bench. All thanks to our great mates at the TAC and their Towards Zero campaign. Got another big show coming up. We have a dual sports star joining us on the program very shortly. We have our country footy roundup with Nathan Currie, our weekly wrap with Hannah Driscoll from the Weekly Times. We have another fantastic City of Ballarat feature story about the historic AFL game last week in the fine city of Ballarat between the Bulldogs and Port Adelaide. And we preview our first two grand finals in country Victoria as I welcome this man, the 97 best and fairest from Geelong. And I'm led to believe there's been a new addition to the Pickering household, Pickers, as I welcome you. And I have the benefit of sitting very closely to, and I cannot help but see all the scratches on both hands. What on earth has happened?
Look, we've got ourselves a pussycat.
And I beg your pardon?
I have been eaten alive.
Yep.
Yeah, well, it's the year of the cat. I just feel like the Geelong are going to get it done.
What's the name of the cat?
Bella.
All right.
And she's playing, but she's scratching me, and I've got a lot of scratches on me at the moment. It's not very good.
No. Just before we introduce our guest tonight, who is an absolute star in both cricket and football, what about last weekend in Ballarat? A magnificent AFL fixture between Port Adelaide and the Bulldogs.
Yeah, it was. It was a wonderful weekend, really. The weather was terrific. There's some really good footy played. You saw that goal. That was an unbelievable goal from Suckling. Great game, surface outstanding, the City of Ballarat right behind it, the Bulldogs fans and flags everywhere. It was a fabulous day. It was a pity from the Dogs' perspective they weren't able to get the job done, but the better team on the day won, and that man, Charlie Dixon, very, very important indeed.
He was. Well done to Port Adelaide getting it done there. Our weekly feature, thanks to the City of Ballarat, will involve a bit more about that historic game. Time now to introduce our guest. She is a star both on the cricket field and the football field, and her name is Emma Carney. Welcome, Emma.
Thanks for having me, boys.
It is good to have you in the middle of football season, Em, because we know you play cricket. We'll get on to the cricket stuff later on, but right in the midst of a VFLW season. So how's it all going?
Yeah, it's going all right. We're currently sitting third on the ladder at the moment. We're going into our last home and away game against Diamond Creek. So if we can knock them off, which hopefully we can, we'll finish second on the ladder and then we'll lead into our final series.
Let's have a look at some of the highlights of your first year, the inaugural year of the AFLW. And here's a bit of your action. A disappointing year for the Dogs with a pretty good team, I would have thought. But you had a very fine season.
Yeah, it certainly was a bit disappointing for us. We started the season with a really good win against Fremantle, but unfortunately we had some injuries to key players, which certainly impacted our season slightly. But, you know, it was awesome to be a part of the season and something I'm really looking forward to in 2018.
Did you expect it? Well, as we have a look at some of your stats here, Swatter.
So, numbers, picks.
Best and fairest winner with one of my girls, Ellie Blackburn, All-Australian. Which is a pretty good effort considering you did have some commitments, some cricket commitments, so you didn't do all the training. You must have enjoyed the season because I don't think anyone saw from an outsider how big it was going to be.
No, not at all. I went to the first game against Carlton Collingwood and 24,000 there at the game was...
Could you believe that?
No, not at all. I was having dinner with a couple of mates beforehand and I sort of said, oh, they'll be lucky to get 10,000 there at the game, and then... You know, to get that many was incredible. And then I think there was about 15,000 at our game against Fremantle. Was certainly a great experience.
It's going to go from strength to strength.
No doubt.
Strength to strength. This competition. I'll get that out finally. No, it was a fabulous first year. The Muggers you play for, the Melbourne Uni Muggers. and you've got some damn good players in your team, some real fine players. Work me from left to right here, who everyone is.
Yeah, so we've got Ellie Blackburn, myself, Caitlin Ashmore, Lou Stevenson and Kat Phillips in there, just to name a few of our AFLW stars.
Now you take on Diamond Creek this weekend. If you win, you go into second. That's just behind the Darabin Falcons. How did you go against, have you played Diamond Creek this year?
Yeah, we did play them. We played it on their home ground.
How'd that go last time?
Oh, not so well. we got done by about 50 points, I think, by them.
Shocking ground, though. It's not
a great ground. They play it very, very well. We've got them at our home ground, which is a bit bigger, so hopefully our run and carry can get the job done.
Well, I'll be going in to watch on Saturday morning at 10:45. Not normally a big crowd, so I'll be able to get a spot, no problems, to watch.
Definitely.
Hey, tell us about the cricket now. I mean, I'm tied up with the Renegades, so you're the opposition. Nice. The Stars, here's you here being interviewed.
Victoria's
during the team. Cricket season, the Melbourne Stars. That must be a thrill playing on the MCG as well.
Yeah, absolutely. It's quite a different experience playing cricket on the MCG as opposed to footy. I suppose footy's so fast-paced that you don't really get a chance to enjoy the experience as such. But, yeah, certainly when you're out in the field, you get to sort of soak it in a bit more.
Yeah, that wasn't you batting, by the way. That was Emma no. Bowling. That was her taking out the off-peg.
I don't pay for that red team. Come on.
I love the red team.
What skills can you take or have you taken from cricket and you've just brought that to your game of footy?
Oh, I think just your natural hand-eye coordination, catching, that kind of thing, you can certainly take from it. In terms of fitness and stuff, I do a lot with cricket as well, so I can take that into my football matches.
Very few are good at both, Emma. I can tell you that Swatter certainly wasn't one of those. Well, he was a one-trick pony, Swatter. He was a good footballer, but gee, he was terrible at cricket.
He's just talking about himself there.
No, I wasn't even mentioning myself, Wayne, but if that's how you took it, that's how you took it. Like what I say. Now, you grew up in the country. You grew up in Cavendish. Talk us through your upbringing, because here's you, and is that Dad and...
The old man Mick.
And brother?
Yep, that's my dad and my younger brother. We just won a cricket premiership there.
We all in the same team?
Yeah, we were.
Oh, dear. Which one are you there, Emma?
Yeah, so I'm the one with the terrible haircut and the red shorts there. But what a cute little face I've got.
And you've got a twin sister.
Yeah. So my sister's, you can't really tell which one's girls really in that photo with the haircuts, but the one on the very left with the blonde hair. Oh. Completely different.
And this, obviously you have a little bit of a break after this weekend, and then you've got the following week, the really exciting Victoria versus Allies game. You must be looking forward to that.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was one thing to play in the AFLW, but this will be take it to the next stage. We've got, 44 of the best in the country playing in the game, and yeah, it should be an absolute cracker.
Well, special players get to play State of Origin games picks, and that's something really to look forward to, Em.
Yeah. I mean, I played the last time I played for the Vics was in 2013 in Cairns. So I haven't been able to put on the big V for a while. So I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, it's going to be outstanding. There'll be a big crowd there too because they used to have, obviously last year, I think they still had that. What was the last year's game? Was it still the Bulldogs in Melbourne?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, the exhibition game. Yeah. But sort of seems to have lost a little bit of, because now you've obviously they've all got different teams.
Exactly.
So this will be fantastic to do. And you've got very much a star-studded lineup. Yours, the Vics, the good team, and those other miserable Allies.
You must
be looking forward to taking them on.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, I mean, there's stars in both of them. Daisy Pearce, to name one in the Vics, but also someone like Chelsea Randall is an absolute star to watch as well in that game. So, it should be an absolute corker, and I'm looking forward to it.
Well, let's hope that the Muggers can get it done against Diamond Creek this weekend at
Hopefully.
Your home ground. Thanks very much for coming in, and we wish you well.
No worries. Thanks for having
me,
guys.
There you go. Emma Carney, an absolute superstar, both on and off the cricket and football field. Hey, Picks, time now to jump into our Carlton Draft. Team of the week, Carlton Draft, Victorian born and bred since 1864.
Yeah, and it's the Frankston YCW Football Club is our team of the week, our Carlton Draft team of the week. Full of legends, the Stonecats. Mm-hmm. 14 flags, pretty good effort, including 2014, 15 and 16. Some of their legends, like Hawthorn dual premiership player Michael McCarthy.
Yep.
And
Jeff White.
And, of course, Dylan Robinson running around.
Great
at
pick
the
up.
Moment. And he's playing some fabulous footy. Here's a little bit of work to do on the grass. I would have thought. Not a lot of grass there, but they got it done in the mud by the looks of that. And 4-goal win. And they finished the season 16-2, Swatter, so it's a pretty good effort.
It certainly is. And they've got a big final series coming up. That was our Carlton Draft Team of the Week, Victorian born and bred since 1864. I tell you what, Carlton Draft do a great amount of work throughout the broader community picks. And they'll continue to do that during the final series for leagues around the state, because Carlton Draft are introducing the Carlton Draft Front Bar.
They are. And some of the major leagues where they are going and setting up a bar at the ground. Fantastic.
Yep, whereabouts?
The Ovens and Murray.
Massive.
Fabulous league. Big crowd. It'll be at Lavington.
Huge.
It normally is. The Murray Football League, Geelong Football League, which is like a big crowd. It'll be at Cat Park.
Yep.
And also Bendigo Football League, which again will probably be a QEO, I would imagine.
Yep.
So proceeds going back to the clubs
Absolutely.
And the leagues. So a fantastic initiative by the Carlton Draft team.
Yes, the Carlton Draft Community Keg Pick is a great initiative. We've got to take our first break. Coming up next, our Country Footy Roundup with Nathan Currie off the bench, thanks to our great mates at the TAC and their Towards Zero campaign, because there is no one someone won't miss. Welcome back to Off the Bench. Thanks to the TAC and their Towards Zero campaign. Time now to jump into our country footy roundup. And that's all thanks to Greyhound Racing supporting 3,000 Victorian jobs as we welcome back the school captain and prefect back in his school days, Nathan Currie from Channel 9 Local News.
Thanks very much, boys. Good to be back.
It is good to have you. Where are we starting this week, Nathan?
We're starting in the West Gippsland Football League. A very bittersweet win for Currie Rupp. They had a one-point win, which usually you'd think that's great for the club, but the slender margin means they've actually missed out on finals by less than 5%. Which is terrible for them. Even worse because it was Ben Collins' last game as a player coach. He's going to stay on in 2018, but only on the sidelines from a non-playing coach point of view. Led by 1 point at three-quarter time too, and then just couldn't increase that margin and just held on for the win.
Okay, this is where the ladder finishes. So first week of finals, it's top five. Obviously the top team, Inverloch, will have the week off, and then it goes down from there, does it? Second, third, fourth, fifth?
Yeah, that's right. And Phillip Island just snuck into the top five there and then plays off against Narnagoon in the elimination final.
So lucky for the Rappers. Mm. The Rappers.
All right, what about the Heathcote District Footy League?
Yeah, Leedsville Gunpowder was far too good for Colbert Abbon. 52-point win at Huntley there. Matthew Perry kicked four more goals. He's now got 112 for the season from just 17 games. The Bombers have been just the clear challenger for North Bendigo. North Bendigo's been flying for the past 3 years in the Heathcote District, and yeah, the Bombers have clearly shown again they're the ones that are a big chance to knock them off. So they're going head to head this Saturday in a semi-final, whereas Colbo, they've got the double chance, so they'll now play Huntley, who had a big win over White Hills.
Now Swatter's from the Riddle District area, aren't you, Swatter? That's your sort of hood.
That's correct, Liam.
So who we got here?
Macedon claimed the minor premiership here with a big win over Diggers Rest. It was Cats. A low scoring affair, but considering the Burrows hardly troubled the scoreboard, the Cats still won by 51 points. Yeah, 51 points. So big win for them. Cale Morton and Taylor Hine played well for the Burrows. They've still limped into the finals. They won the premiership last year, so they're still ticking along. But yeah, they certainly couldn't get the win against Macedon, who has, as I said, claimed the minor premiership now.
It's pretty tight though. I mean, you'd think any one of those top sort of four or five could win. I mean, there's not a lot. It's not like there's a standout team. I'm asking, yes, they've had a good season, good percentage, etc. But Rupert's were not far behind, and Diggers Rest, which is Swatter's team, not far behind again.
Diggers Rest.
Well, you're a Diggers Rest.
I live in Gisborne, young man.
You're a Diggers Rest.
What about the Golden Valley Footy League?
Yeah, well, Rochester had a big win over Echuca. Now, I was doing a bit of research, boys, and Rochester Football Club formed with the sole purpose of playing and beating Echuca, and they certainly did that on the weekend. 91 points. Echuca was terribly inaccurate. 10 goals, one goal 10 to three-quarter time. Former AFL player Simon Buckley, his phenomenal season for Echuca has just continued. Another best-of-field performance from them. But as you can see, Rochester got the win. But yeah, it's going to be tough to stop Kai Abram. They're still flying with one round to go in
Kane,
the home and away season.
Kane Pettifer's boys there on fire at the moment.
Hey, what about Nattymuck United? What have they done?
Yeah, well, they're the first Nattymuck team in 20 years to play finals. They're playing in the Horsham District League.
Good effort.
Yeah, the club formed following the 2013 season. Nattymuck merged with Horsham United. So really pleasing signs for them.
And talking about playing finals for the first time, buckle up. Got it done after its 16th start, I'm led to believe, picks.
Yeah, buckle up, York at Cranbourne. Unbelievable performance, the number three dog. Have a look at the three dog get away. Now, it was unplaced for the first 14,
yeah, then
right?
Came second in its 15th and then finally got the win here in Cranbourne last week. So
Pam Burns, who trains the dog, very good job to get it home at the 16th. Fitty! Which I did have a little something on, I must say, $16.50. So well done to Buckle Up York, and well done to you, Nathan.
Mm. Hey, thanks, Piggs.
Hey, nice job tonight.
Yeah, his glasses on before. Mm. I want to see you. Look, there, put them on. You look about 10 years older with
you.
Hey, very mature.
Look like he's 12. There you go.
Very mature with those glasses.
Just want to take after Swatter.
Yep, the most famous utility player in all of country Victoria. Nath, fantastic to have you on again tonight. We'll see you again same time next week.
Sounds good, boys.
There we go, Nathan Currie. And that was our country footy roundup, all thanks to Greyhound Racing Victoria. And that's putting every dog first on and off the track. Hannah Driscoll will join us next with the weekly wrap. But as we head to the break, let's have a look at the TAC's Safe Series. And this is a message to everybody, including us, Bix and Nath, that we can all choose to get the road toll down towards zero by choosing safer speeds every time we're on the road. Let's have a look at a couple of famous people doing some great work for our mates at the TAC.
Excellent evening for it, Isaac, and the Rovers are in fine form.
They sure are, Pickers, and ooh, there's a bit of force in that one. That'll make you grateful for your teeth.
That's right. Even at low speeds, we're seeing impact that put a charging hippo to shame.
Poor comparison there, Pickers, but you're bang on. Every speed has its consequences, just like on the road.
Indeed. Our bodies are simply not designed to travel at high speed, and as soon as we hit the accelerator, we start to create risk. Risks that make these hits look like a cuddle from your grandmother.
But the good news is you as the driver can control these risks. So take care out there and choose safer speed.
Head up, boys.
Welcome back to the program, thanks to the TAC and their Towards Zero campaign. Time now to jump straight into our weekly wrap. With the Weekly Times, Hannah Driscoll, the voice of the country. Welcome back, Hannah. Great to have your company again.
Thanks very much, gents.
Where are we starting this week, Hannah?
So big news for the South East region. AFL South East on Tuesday night revealed the final recommendations for its review into senior football. And to say that they weren't entirely well received is probably an understatement. Hampden Park has already voted to leave the South East League and apply to join Southern League. It was a move that they tried to make last year. And a bunch of the Nepean and Peninsula clubs also walked out of that meeting on Tuesday.
There was always going to be fallout. Yeah. Some clubs or some people were never going to be happy with whatever findings were made, were they?
Yes. Yeah, so it's a very emotive topic whenever you try to talk about changes to leagues. But the changes that they're bringing in are pretty significant. It's certainly caused a bit of debate over the last couple of months in that part of the world.
And what about one of our old mates, Luke Dyer? He's done it again.
This is amazing. Luke Dyer has become just the second player in the East Gippsland League to win a fourth league best and fairest. So he went back-to-back in 2009 and 10, and he's just gone back-to-back again, all for Lindeno Football Club. And in between those years, he's actually playing at Bairnsdale. So that makes it four out of four for the years that he's been playing in the East Gippsland League. So well done to him.
Absolutely. And he was actually... the other week, Spotter, we had him as one of our heroes in the Carlton Draft
Team
of the Week from Lindeno Cats, the Pussycats. Now, the women's grand final's coming up, I believe.
Yes, we've got a big grand final this week, and in the Northern Football League Division 1, Bendigo Thunder will be taking on Diamond Creek. Bendigo Thunder actually finished minor premier, but then lost to Diamond Creek in the semi-final. So they've had to take the scenic route through to the final. And it'll be interesting to see if they can make it 2 from 2 for the club, because Bendigo Thunder actually won the Northern Country Women's Final
just
as well.
Give us a tip. Who do you think will win that one?
Oh, I've got to go the Country Girls.
There we go.
Yep. Back of me all the way.
And what about the Armyown District?
Armyown District League is also playing their grand final, so the first for the country men's final. So Lindeno South taking on Bruthen. Lindeno South will be going for 3 in a row if they can pull it off.
Yeah. Tell you what, Yuri's made a strong comeback
again. Not happy last week.
No, not happy he got superseded, but he's back with our photo of the week this week.
He is back. This was a snap from the Romsey v Wallen game. This game essentially was going to decide which of these two teams played in the finals, and the win went to Romsey, so they will be playing the Riddle District finals this weekend.
Yeah, well done, Hannah. Thank you very much for your contribution there, and you can read all of Hannah's articles and the National Rural News Fresh Daily at theweeklytimes.com.au. We've got to take a break. When we come back, our TAC Great Country clashes, and we may preview the Omeo Grand Final again, but as we head to the break, our final City of Ballarat feature story, and we cannot go past the historic AFL game. AFL has arrived in Ballarat, and they hosted the Bulldogs in Port Adelaide last weekend.
It's been a very exciting lead up to our very first and historic AFL game here in Ballarat. Ballarat's all about history, and what we've got here is the most amazing stadium and a significant opportunity for many other events.
It's really exciting because it's never been done before. The closest thing I could connect it to is something like traveling to Geelong. I live in Mornington, so it's a 2-hour and 10-minute ride to Geelong for me when we've got a game. And the difference is, obviously, when we're going to Geelong, it's a hostile environment, and here in Ballarat, it's our home game. The stadium looks amazing, and I think that apart from the fact that we haven't got our nice roof at Etihad, which can keep us nice and warm, it'll be a really good day with really good support for the boys.
We had 42 travel over on our bus. It took us about 8 hours to get here. We left 11 p.m. Adelaide time Friday night and arrived here at Ballarat at 7:40 local time. The stadium's come together really well from what I can see, and the weather's cooperating at the moment, so hopefully it'll be a good day out.
It was only a few minutes between the gates opening and the crowds absolutely settling into this amazing space. Before we knew it, we could see every seat full, and the crowds even in the standing area, shoulder to shoulder, exactly what we'd hoped for.
Roughhead drives inside 50, Dunkley at ground level, snaps creatively, snaps accurately.
Pollock from 40 out, he was celebrating the moment it left his boot, and that is game over. Port are going to win.
It was really good to get out there and play in a really good deck and obviously get the win as well. When the draw came out, we saw that we were playing here and obviously had a look because it's my birthday today as well. So we've been from Shanghai to Ballarat, so it was a really good experience for us.
Great atmosphere out there. You could certainly hear them and it felt like they were nice and close to the action. So hopefully there were a lot of fans that enjoyed their days. The ground itself is immaculate. It's like a carpet out there. So. I'm sure the boys are looking forward to making Ballarat our second home in the years to come.
This is not it yet. This is just a start of something really big. We know how important it is for our CBD to absolutely grow and flourish. This is the beginning of a flourishing Ballarat.
Welcome back to the program. Time now to have a look at our great country clashes. That's all thanks to the TAC because there's no one someone won't miss.
First grand final spotter, and it's the Omeo and District Football League. Lindeno South versus Bruthen. Mm-hmm. The Swampies have got a nice little record, 3-1 over the Dogs this year. Yep. And look, with that great goal kicker, Max Solomon, who's averaging something like 7.5 goals a game. Yep. He's up 114 goals in 15
good
games.
Effort.
Good effort. You'd think that the Swamps will be a little bit too strong in that game, but I'm glad it sort of feels like it, that one day in August, doesn't
yes,
it?
Yes,
really?
One day in
it's
August.
It's very hard to get it.
It is.
Mike Brady's going to do a new song. He's going to have to change one to day August and October. Yeah, like,
well, he'll get is paid that, for it. Well, hey, just quickly, happens. Do you see the top eight changing with one more round of game to go? Melbourne take on Collingwood, Essendon take on Freo this weekend.
No, I think Melbourne will handle Collingwood, and I think Essendon will obliterate the Fremantle Dockers, who to me are the worst team in the AFL by as far as you can kick your hat.
All right. Written and spoken by Liam Pickering, well, and I tend to agree.
Well, have a look at them. They've lost by 100 points the last 2 weeks.
All right. Well done, Pickers. Please. Well done to Emma Carney for joining us. Thanks to Nathan Currie and Hannah Driscoll. Have a great weekend. Good luck to the teams playing the Omeo Grand Final. Same time next week off the bench. We'll be back.